Morning, morning, morning. It's Wednesday. So I want to talk about business and survival of our businesses, but I'll get to that at the very end when I talk about some personal tips and advice. If you don't know, I get on here every morning, Monday to Friday, and talk about the business of marketing and Facebook and Google marketing and what's going on in the world because the world's crazy. So yeah. Hi, Trent. So if you guys don't know already, this group is about marketing and business and collaboration and supporting one another. So know right now you can post anything in the group, post your blog post, self-promote, go on a live. So all those things are in the group. We're trying to make a community where people can come, talk to others, and actually make friends because the new way of making friends is online, right? Hello, Maura. Hello, Gaynor. Hello, Karen. Hi, guys. Lovely to see you this morning. It's Wednesday. I got some news for you today about Google and Facebook that's pretty interesting and might even be a little interesting for the kids. Okay, so let's get into it real quick, right? And then we'll talk about survival and business and advice there. And if you have advice to share on business and survival, drop them in the comments. Yep, you need to get back to it. What do you need to get back to? Karen, business? Yes, maybe. Okay, so Google and Facebook are both losing oodles of money with advertising right now. Google's actually giving businesses a ad credit, and we worked it out because it's like $34 million or something, but there's 7 million businesses. Anyway, it works out to about $40 a business. That's kind of interesting. But other than that, I mean, it's really nice that they're doing that. If anyone else in here has been in any other type of marketing field, they'll know, like when I was in the newspaper business, when Google and Facebook came out, basically, they start to lose money. And so that's happening more and more. And France and Australia have now forced, because they won a court case where they're now forced to pay media companies. So I thought that was interesting. Oh, Karen, yes, you do have to go live more. I've been missing your dancing. And I think it's very effective. I really am enjoying coming on first thing in the morning. And hello, Sherry. Okay, so other major changes in Google that we're seeing that we need to pay attention to as marketers is Google Merchant Center and Google Shopping. So if you guys don't know, Google used to have like its shopping feature free, and then lots of things changed, and then it is no longer free, and it was like Google forward slash shopping. Well, now they're gonna make it look like the regular search engine results pages. So you'll have ads at the top, and it's all for shopping. It's like so commerce, e-commerce. I actually heard something really funny today. So we call it e-commerce because it's online. And so there's this underground cyberpunk, yes, cyberpunk phrasing that in real life commerce will be called meat commerce. I thought that was interesting. Anyway, I heard that from Phelan. He's pretty up on this stuff. So other really interesting Google things is, did you know that I bet you can guess this, but the virus and anything about the virus has been searched more than anything else on Google. It's surpassed every kind of search. And I mean, is that news? Would we just assume that? We might just assume that. But it's interesting to know. Okay, there's some Facebook really big news today, which is really interesting. But before I get to that, do you do Google Alerts? Are your Google Alerts, so Google's RSS feed into your mailbox, and you can ask for different things to, different news resources to be grouped together and sent to you in your inbox. Well, it's broken, or it feels really broken, and I am not the only one. So if you get those alerts, know you might have to do your manual searches to get the information you want. And if you haven't used Google Alerts before, check it out. Just type into Google Alerts. It's pretty cool. Okay, so the other things, yes, I have notes. I have notes. Facebook, okay, big news, guys. A couple big things. First of all, if you didn't know, Facebook's like investing in India, which we might not think is a really big deal, but when they invest $5.7 billion and they are now the minority shareholder of the largest internet company there, it says a lot that that India is booming with technology and innovation. So it's a place to watch. We'll see what happens with all that's going on now. Now, the other really interesting news, I thought that was pretty big news, by the way. Facebook Messenger for kids. So if you have kids, it's kind of looking like Facebook's kind of angling themselves to maybe be a place for education and kids, kind of like Google does for Google Class. But yeah, so there's some parameters rolling out to groups about permissions and kids. Facebook Messenger now, I guess there's going to be Messenger chats. Maybe they'll actually do some education on Messenger. What do you think of that? Do you think that could happen? So yeah, and in my notes on my blog post, there'll be all the links to all these articles. It's pretty interesting. There's been some definite weird things about kids and Facebook. So it's actually being rolled out, Messenger, Facebook for kids, rolled out to more countries now. So it was just in the US, and now it's going to be in India, Peru, I think, lots of other places. So yeah, so that's the news today. That was fast, huh? But let's talk about, what's going on. Let's talk about business and survival. We've never been here before, right? And I don't know about you, but like I have severe ups and downs. Like we in our business, like I know some of my marketing friends have lost all their clients because they were working with them and they were in the travel industry. So that sucked, right? Right away, bang, done. But there's a lot of us who are slowly but surely losing clients because those clients are in different industries that are being affected. And this is where it gets gritty. And this is where the knockdown effects we see are taking effect, right? We lost one of our favorite clients yesterday. And yes, we are still going to continue to help them because when they can do business again in a few months, we're going to be there because we want to work for them. So, first note, if you're in marketing and you're losing clients, are you doing anything to sidestep that? Are you doing anything to really help those people survive? Because it's survival mode now. And kids aren't getting fed, rents aren't getting paid. Like, this is real. I mean, not that you don't know it's real, but it's hard, right? We know that in a recession, lots of businesses fail. And we don't want to be one of those businesses. I sure don't. I live in a place I love. And I love working with the people that I work with, and I love what I do. And I have to make sure that I stay in it, work hard, support businesses. So even if you're losing work, maybe find a way to do more work. But the reason I'm saying all of this is because there is a way to stand out. There is a way to get on top of things and to set yourself apart. And it comes in the form of treating this, as weird as this is going to sound, and this is just my opinion, treating this like your own personal education vacation, right? You need to not only observe your own behavior and what you're doing online, because that's going to transcend through a lot of other people, and business, and how you're searching for businesses, how you're interacting with businesses. If we pay attention to this, maybe we can help the businesses we work with by supporting them and angling things, because we want them to be the two-thirds of businesses that survive, right? We don't want them to be that one-third. And we know as marketers that the best way and the most effective way is the top of the funnel stuff, right? They don't know you. Like now for the electrician or the plumber, there's going to be a lot more competition. So how do you stand out? You got to work with your organic and I mean, maybe even do some paid. Not that I'm recommending spending money if you don't have it. But there's lots of ways to be innovative. And when I say it's a education vacation, that means all those things you wanted to learn or get better at. There's so many resources, and make yourself a plan for how you're going to learn it and become the expert you already are, but like even better, right? Like just become the best you can. Who knows if we're going to live tomorrow? Not that that's a positive thing to say, but shouldn't that spark us? Shouldn't that put like a flame under our butt to make us live and try to excel? And that's my line for today. There's my 2 cents. So if you don't know, I get on here Monday to Friday to talk about business and marketing and share my personal thoughts, it seems. So if you get an opportunity, I dare you to go live in the group. You can go live anytime. And you know what? People need it. I need it. I'm looking for some fun and some love and some happiness today because I had a hard day at the end of the day yesterday. I plan on having a really good day today, but that's because I'm going to make that happen. What about you? Do you have things that you need to tell people? How are you supporting people? And how are you changing your business? I would really love to know because that really helps me. It'll help others. Anyway, you know the drill. Get on here, communicate with others, make a new friend today, and I will see you tomorrow morning. Okay, bye.